Chain waits.
Ah, it's the other kind. Variety is so important.
Yeah.
I, for one, never doubted.
Right.
Until gods grow good.
Could be quite a wait.
Nah. They're just waiting for us.
Piece of the language cipher.
Good.
Yeah. Roy.
Yes, sir?
Time to flip the temple.
Yes, sir.
Let's just agree to stop saying flip the temple. It's starting to sound normal.
Look here. Another.
It says his name is Burgomir. I think Mother said he was the king of the forest.
Aye, that he was. And quite a bit more.
Looks like he had a lot of kids.
That, little brother, is what we call an understatement.
He's dead, but nobody killed him. Do giants die from old age?
They may, though it's rare among the legends. Brothers, I know what I promised, but in case this doesn't work, just remember, Tyr had good cause to create these obstacles. He's kept Jotunheim out of Odin's reach, but the world is hardly at peace.
No, but it's got hope. We're all working together now. We have unity. That's what the rune on the door to this place was telling us. We're on Tyr's path.
Lift with your legs, brother.
He knows.
Just trying to be helpful. I'll be quite happy to be on your side.
See that, Mimir? Nobody can do all this alone. All these obstacles, they're just chances to prove we're the ones who can beat them. We may argue. Me and Father, you and Freya, Brock and Sindri. But when we all work together, we do make a good team. And that's Tyr's test. That's why we're gonna make it to Jotunheim.
Do you hear that, brother? Lad's found his equilibrium.
What's that mean?
He means you speak wisely, Atreus. And that is good to hear.
Ha! I guess the temple was made to be flipped.
Look, the tree's upside down. Or are we? I'm not sure anymore.
Roy, your knife.
Well, what have we got?
Some sort of travel stone.
Let me see. Great, Arundumlazarus. That's the Unity Stone.
You know it.
I wasn't sure it existed. If Tyr possessed this, that explains how he could visit all the realms and other lands to boot.
He held this in the panel in Odin's library.
Yes. Yes, that's it. I understand now. It shows Tyr walking the realm between realms. You know how you must never stray from the path. Well, Tyr always followed his own path, if you catch my meaning.
The realm between realms.
So you're saying Tyr's shrine showed him stepping off the branch of the world tree. And you're thinking, to reach the secret path to Jotunheim, that's what we need to do?
I am.
Dear, that is what you're thinking, isn't it?
I need that alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find him.
Looks good.
Where were we on that other thing?
If you're thinking about hurling us. Into the void, I hope you're quite sure.
Wasn't it your idea? Find our own path, right?
Well, this is where Tyr stepped beyond, and the Unity Stone protected him. Ready?
Ready.
Well, if this is it, lads, it's been an honor.
Our faith, Head.
This is incredible!
How can I be so nauseous without a stomach?
Come on, that was great.
Look.
The tower. I knew there was something down here.
Amazing. How do you hide something that exists in all realms? Cast it out of any realm to the space between. Clever old Tyr.
Is Jotunheim on the other side?
Can't be that. It's not like you go through Vanaheim to reach the Midgard Peak.
But how do we use it?
I'd suggest we look inside, but stay alert. Tyr's little challenges are never as simple as they appear.
I have noticed.
Well, this is sparse.
The pedestal.
Oh no! It took the stone!
Tower. It's absorbing the stone's energy.
Something's happening! Is it moving? It's moving!
It knows what to do! The stone served its purpose! We're fulfilling Tyr's spell!
What happens now?
No idea, brother. But after that fall, I'm sure we're past the worst of it. Oh, oh, this is considerably worse!
On your left!
I know what's up!
Sorry, not ready! Where do you think it's taking us next?
I do not know.
Oh no! We're back in hell?
Oh dear, here they come.
Enemies ahead!
Where are we?
Look! We're back in Midgar. There's the bridge! We did it! The tower's back where it belongs!
Now Tyr's travel room can take us to Jotunheim.
How did Tyr do this?
Odin suspected the giant secretly possessed some remnant of primordial Jotnar creative essence, the stuff all realms were made of. The Unity Stone must have been fashioned from that essence. To trust an outsider with it, even Tyr, tells you just how desperate they were.
And look, now we can finally light all the braziers and see what happens.
Tyr's braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you may.
We've seen these runes before, but it's the kind I still can't read.
You fellas sure love to make a racket, don't you? Well, see you next time you need something.
I don't know what we'll find when we get to Jotunheim, but we must cover our tracks. Odin's ravens will tell him of the tower's restoration, and we mustn't let our efforts be to his benefit.
Very well.
Wait a minute. This isn't going to work.
What?
There's no travel crystal. Tyr must have used his own eyes to refract the energy. It was his final failsafe.
You got eyes like him, Mimir.
I've got an eye. One! Odin plucked out my other eye precisely to keep me from traveling. Sorry, lads. Thought that would work.
What did Odin do with your other eye?
He'd have kept it. Any of 100 places, I'm afraid.
We've come so far. There has to be a way.
Look, bit of a long shot, but for years I'd see Sindri, sometimes Brock, lurking around in that mountain when Odin came for his visits. Maybe they know something.
Brock and Sindri! Hey guys, question for you. Anyone know where we can find Mimir's other eye?
Oh. That's... I'm sorry. As a matter of fact, Odin asked me to... He wanted me to build a... He showed it to me, you see, and I... Declined. Sorry. Will you excuse me?
Well, that was useless.
You know, it was about that same time that Odin came around looking for me to build a statue with some sort of hidden compartment. Now, that not being a weapon and the Aesir being a bunch of pox-speckled cockers, I too saw fit to decline. But I know we got it built just the same.
What was the statue?
It's that one of Thor.
We're supposed to look inside the snake.
Inside? Oh, no.
We'd better go see what the World Serpent has to say about that.
Well, lads, I don't know what lies ahead, but now would be a good time to make sure your gear is ready. Once more to the horn.
Statue in his mood to fall.
Skill.
he thinks it might still be in his stomach. And he's open to letting you go into his mouth to look inside.
Ew. Really?
By the by, he's not wild about it either.
So, are we really doing this? Letting the serpent swallow us?
You do not have to come.
Well, I'm not gonna miss this.
Betray us! To me!
Okay, I'm coming! You sure this is a good idea?
No.
I see something down there.
Well, brothers, I've been to many strange places, but this will be a new one.
Yeah, I've never been in the giant's belly either. How about you, father?
Never one that was not trying to eat me.
We really should expect that sort of response at this point.
I used to dream about getting eaten.
Dreams are nothing.
I'm not afraid. It just reminded me of a way I used to feel when I was a child. Let's find that statue.
Ah, smells not as bad as I thought it'd be. Bit like heather ale fermenting. That pleasant, actually.
You're so weird. I see something down there. The water kind of burns in here. That is water, isn't it?
Aye.
Most of it.
You want a beach here?
There, the hammer.
Any idea where Odin hid your eye?
No. It's not like I can still see through it.
Huh! can decipher those Niflheim rings. And the travel rune is here too. You wanna go? Yep, that's an eye.
Maybe you should stick that in my head, for safekeeping. Gently now, gently. Thank you, brother. You don't miss depth until it's gone. Well, I wouldn't say I'm feeling whole again, but it's a right improvement.
The Bifrost is intact.
It'll serve.
Then we have all we need.
Finally, we're going to Yudna. There's no stopping us now.
Laddie, have you ever heard the term tempting fate?
Out.
We signal.
Hold on! What's going on? Well, that was mildly terrifying. Maybe our presence is upsetting Jormungandr's belly.
No. Something is wrong.
What's happening to you?
Nothing good! Glad that's over.
Is he getting hit? What is that?
We must hurry.
Couldn't agree more, brother.
Hold tight and watch your balance.
The board shifting! I'm gonna...
to this. What happened to him? Something we did?
No. Something else. A dead giant. Why would the serpent leave us here?
Look! Trust her, right?
Until we know for certain, keep her distance.
The world serpent. What's happened here?
We hoped you would know.
You are far from home.
I'm looking for my son. The two of you. You helped me see things more clearly.
You do not know where he is then?
No. But the woods and fields speak his name. I know he walks here in Midgard.
When did you see him last?
Long ago. Before you were even born. Why are you standing so far from me? What's wrong? Something's happened.
There!
I had a feeling that hurting the big snake would bring the two of you out in the open. Do you have any idea at all, what you have cost me?
My boy.
Mother.
I'm here. Don't run away.
Oh, I'm not going anywhere, Mother.
I know that you're still angry. I know that how you feel hasn't changed, but I want you...
How I feel? How I feel? I've spent the last 100 years dreaming of this moment. I've rehearsed everything I ever wanted to say to you, every word, to make you understand exactly what you stole from me. But now, I realize I don't need you to understand anything. I don't need you at all.
Oh, back off, Kratos. This has nothing to do.
This path you walk, vengeance. You will find no peace. I know.
You? I'll deal with you later. But family first. This again? Turn away, boy. This won't be pretty.
I won't let you hurt him.
No, boy.
Fine.
Stop! No! Atreus! You're bleeding. Breathe, boy. Breathe!
Not my blood.
What is that? I can feel this. I can feel everything.
No! He's vulnerable now?
More than harmed. The spell is broken.
He can be killed.
I'm certain of it. It's all coming back now.
Now he remembers. She's controlling that thing?
Stay out of it. him!
No, woman! You cannot! He means to kill you!
You can't stop me! No one can!
Where is he?
I don't care if he kills me. I will protect him. I will not let him die.
Don't touch him. This will all be over soon. Going to feel so rewarding now. More! More! Show me more!
We shall not do this!
I feel! Freezing!
No! Stop hurting my boy!
Atreus!
I'm up here! I'm okay!
And I'm doing wonderful! I've never felt so alive!
Stop this! Kariba!
More! More! Show me more! Incredible! Father himself could not. I've never felt more alive. Ironic, isn't it?
Oh!
not done, boy.
Yourself. Can you, Mother? No matter what I do or say, you won't stop interfering in my life.
I was just trying to protect you. I've made mistakes. I know. But you're free now. You have what you want. Try to find forgiveness. We can build something new.
No. No. We can. Because I will never forgive. You still need to pay for the lifetime that you stole from me.
I have paid. I have paid. But if that alone will make you whole, if seeing me dead will make things right, I won't stop.
I know.
What? No, Father!
I love you.
Why do you even care? You could have walked away.
The cycle ends here. Must be better than this.
Down every agony, every violation imaginable upon you. I will parade your cold body from every corner of every realm and feed your soul to the vilest filth in hell. That is my promise.
He saved your life.
He robbed me of everything. Everything. You were just an animal. Passing on your cruelty and rage, you will never change.
And you do not know me.
I know enough. Does he?
Boy. Listen close. I'm from a land called Sparta. I made a deal with the god that cost me my soul. I killed many who were deserving. And many who were not. I killed my father.
That was your father in hell. Is this what it is to be a god? Is this how it always ends? Sons killing their mothers? Their fathers?
No. We will be the gods we choose to be. Not those who have been. Who I was is not who you be. We must be better.
Well, guess we are the bad guys now.
In her eyes, yes. But she could never make that choice. This journey while I still have strength.
I don't understand. I know saving her was the right thing. She seemed all evil.
Not evil. You killed her son, lad. Her son. The death of a child is not something a parent gets over easily.
He was gonna kill her.
She would have died to see him live. Can understand.
So you'd let me kill you?
If it meant you would live. Yes.
Look, there was no easy choice. For anybody, brother. But I think we can all agree you did the right thing. The world's a better place with Freya in it. Just give her time, lads. She'll come around.
Back to Tyr's Temple, then. One last time.
Aye. Jotunheim awaits.
Why did Baldur say we cost
him? Odin must have convinced him that following you to Jotunheim would bring his cure. Lies, I'm sure.
Why did Mistletoe break the spell?
Vanir magic is powerful, but its rules are slippery and elusive. I'm sure it makes sense if you're a witch. Oh, but it's also bloody tragic. Baldur was the greatest gift Odin granted Freya. The one thing she treasured from their marriage. She only hoped to spare him pain and spare herself loss. But such impulses can lead good parents to make terribly stupid decisions.
A Valkyrie. Imprisoned. She actually did it.
A Valkyrie? But I thought they were just spirits.
Take caution, lads. A Valkyrie in the flesh. I can't think of a more formidable opponent.
She does not attack.
Does she even know we're here?
You have freed me from my corrupted form. You have my eternal gratitude. But my sisters remain trapped as I was. Take my helm. Find them. Free them. The fate of the Valkyries rests on your shoulders.
Fate of the Valkyries.
Sounds pretty important.
That's putting it mildly, lad.
What do you know of them?
A fair question, and yet not one easily answered. I know more than most, but much of their history is veiled in secrecy. My own experience with the Valkyries ends with my imprisonment.
You are avoiding the question, Ed.
As I said, brother, it's complicated. I don't know why or how they become such wretched creatures. But perhaps if we can free more of them.
You want us to find more of those things?
The fate of the Valkyries, lad. A more worthy endeavor there is not.
It will be dangerous.
Well, that hasn't stopped you before, eh? That's the spirit.
Yeah!
another one here.
Ah, you know this one, don't you?
It's Thamur, the giant stonemason. Is he building a wall around Jotunheim?
It was to be his masterwork. He only wanted to protect his people.
Too bad the first part got burned.
I'd prefer the last panel was burned. Such a senseless pity.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Thjörgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Thjörgun was gone, lonely ages passed. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath this bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I could scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. Oh, he won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
Scare up that alchemist, what needed finding? Whatever.
Here we go! I can't believe we're gonna see the giants!
Well, if things work according to plan, go ahead and lock in Jotunheim and we'll be on our way. Probably.
Ready.
Oh, right. Got it. Let's hope this doesn't cause you to explode or anything.
Oh, hadn't considered that. Maybe we should talk about this a bit more.
Nah, I'm sure he'll be fine. Ready?
That's unpleasant!
Now, boy!
A word, please, before we continue. Listen, the last thing you two need up there is a decomposing heat ruin in the moment. Why don't I wait for you here? This is between you and the boy.
True. But if someone were to fight...
My Lady Sif's soft, perfect sloshers. You done did it.
Sorry. We had to see this.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. Fine, damn it. Fine.
Watch the head till we return.
I can do this. No, no, I can't. Oh.
Okay.
Ready. Come.
Fingers. I can see the highest peak ahead. Right over there. We did it.
We did.
What are you doing?
I have nothing more to hide.
Can we go now? We're so close.
Boy. Boy.
It's nothing. I just thought I'd hear voices by now. Hello? Anybody here?
What is this place?
They must have all come through here when they left Midgard. What was left of them.
Why carve all these faces?
What if this is all the giants that got out of Midgard alive? Not really many at all. Odin and Thor, ruining everything for everybody.
they now?
The giants came back home so they could survive. But I'm not sure they did. Huh. Who's the guardian? I should feel them, but I don't. This place is dead. What happened? Why'd Mom send us here?
One question is answered, and two more take its place.
Wait! Father! Something's happening! Your axe. It's Muller. Look. She's arguing with a bunch of giants. She knew giants? That's us. The first time we met the world serpent. But how? And our fight with Baldur. But that just happened. Wait. They knew everything that was going to happen. The dragon in the mountain. The stone mason. All these drawings. This is our story.
No. This is your story.
But what does it all mean?
That I was not the only parent with secrets.
You didn't know. She was a giant. I'm a giant. Why didn't she tell us?
She sent us here knowing we would find this.
But why not just tell us the truth?
Her mother would have had good reasons. Baldur was never sent to find me. He was tracking her all along, not knowing she was only ashes.
If she had a plan for us, I trust it. Whatever it is. Besides, she hasn't been wrong yet. Come on. We're so close to the end now.
Yes. Yes, we are.
Look, it's Mother's. She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us. Watching over us. Leading us home. Let's finish it. giants. They really are all gone. There's nothing for us here.
Come.
So, I get that Mother was a giant. Which makes me part giant and part god.
And part mortal.
Right. I guess there's just one thing I don't understand. My name on the wall. The giants called me Loki?
Loki? That's the name your mother wanted for you when you were born. She must have called you that to her people.
But why?
A question for another day. Let us go home.
Makes sense now. Why she want to end up here? Be with her kind? But did she know it was going to be like this here? Is this what she wanted us to see? Did she want us to tell the people? Or keep it a secret?
I do not know.
So what should we do?
I trust you to decide that.
Oh. So why'd you want to name me Atreus? I know it can't be for a god.
No. He was a soldier. A Spartan.
A great warrior?
All Spartans are great warriors. We trained from birth. Our lives were discipline, duty, battle, and death. Life was grim, and we greeted it grimly. But Atreus of Sparta was unlike the rest of us. He wore a smile even in the worst of times. He was happy. He inspired us to hope that though we were machines of war, yet there was humanity in us. Goodness. When the day came for him to lay down his life in battle, his sacrifice saved countless others and turned the tide in our favor. I carried him home on his shield and buried him with all the honors of Spartan custom. His memory was a comfort in dark times.
You actually told a good story. Amir missed it. I understand if you want to go home, but I bet there are still some corrupted Valkyries out there that could be set free. Some other helping people. Maybe helping people is part of why Mom sent us out here, too. I mean, what would Atreus of Sparta do?
And what would Loki do?
That's a weird name. I'm glad we went with yours.
Lads, am I glad to see you. I believe I've reached my limit for dwarven charm.
What happened, Mimir?
They took an uncomfortable number of measurements and then proceeded to bicker about the weather.
Where do you want us to take you?
How about the warm confines of anywhere bloody else?
Odin is extremely clever, he's nearly as clever as he thinks he is. And he's a collector of prophecies. If it's about the future, he adds it to his collection. Helps him style himself as all-seeing and all-knowing. But of course, the idea is control. Control of the future, control of his fate. He'd control every realm of every land in every world if he could. Every potential point of resistance, he seeks to eliminate. Even if you've never posed a threat before, he may think one day you might. So you see, it's not important how he knew before you did. It's important that he was right.
That alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find him.
Ah, Niflheim. Not sure why anyone would want to come here, but here we are.
It smells bad. What is that stuff? Weird.
Yes, a strange material.
This stuff.
This mist is cursed.
Cursed?
Quite right. Safe to breathe for a time, but it'll kill if we linger. Just one more reason to love Niflheim.
Roy, over here.
Yes, sir. Let's see.
Fancy seeing you two here.
I'm surprised you're here, Sindri. This mist is pretty gross.
You think I can't handle a little cursed mist? Well, you're right. I'm trying to build some armor that will lessen its effects. The materials I need are all right here in Ivaldi's workshop, but they're blanketed by this nauseating mist, of course.
Wait for it.
The last known location for such armor is in the workshop center chamber. The entrance is sealed, but I could craft you an entry stone with enough mist echoes.
There it is.
Very well. To business. I wouldn't recommend staying in the mist for too long. That stench will stick to your hair, your weapons, your armor. And I will not touch your gear until you burn all the tiny beasties off in the fires of Muspelheim. Also, it will kill you. I suppose you prefer my brother's work? You're wrong, of course.
Ah! must be the center chamber.
Evaldi sure did a number on this place. Not that there was much to see before. Still, the echoes remain, ready for plunder.
How about you, young one?
That's fine. Always happy just to chat.
I'm feeling creative today.
Oh, what? Nothing? Oh, okay.
There's something written here. This whole place shuffles around each time we leave? That's incredible.
Atreus, focus. This is a dangerous place.
That's dwarven creativity for you. Impressive and dangerous.
Get over! almost ready!
Ooh, looks like you found enough echoes. And you're not dead. Very impressive.
Sindri, how do you make anything out of mist?
Odd as it sounds, the dwarves who lived here could craft the marvels out of the mists of Niflheim. Keep an eye out for more mist echoes. I could put them to all sorts of use. If you're not in a hurry. Ooh, looks like you found enough echoes. And you're not dead. Very impressive.
It's thinner up here. That's nice. Is that the armor? It looks kind of run down. Can you wear it?
No. It is too small and too old. We will bring it back to the dwarf.
Time to go!
Is that what I think it is?
Useless armor?
Useless? Oh, ye of little faith, this armor was worn by Ivaldi himself. Sure, it's seen better days, but I can restore it with more mist echoes, and it'll help with the effects of Ivaldi's curse.
Unless there is something of value in this workshop, there is little point in staying here.
You saw all the chests in the center chamber, yes? Plus all the goodies tucked away towards the back of the workshop?
Why's that?
It's a literal t- Where shall we begin? You don't need to make excuses to say hello.
Ah! Right side!
Time to go!
Thank you.
seriously, be careful with those realm tears.
Piece of work,
if I say so myself. Until we meet again, my friend. ends? What speaks to you? Seeing ya.
Thank you.
behind you! Look out!
Supposedly, the Realm Tears contain some kind of terrible secret Ivaldi wanted hidden. But who knows, really? Dwarves are strange. And yes, I realize I'm a dwarf. Sometimes the best purchase is the one we don't...
Thank you.
To start heading to a mist-free area.
Need a fresh upgrade before tackling the Realm Tears? Not that I condone such an action, mind you. Now, there is something else to tell.
So what brings you around, friends?
Don't forget to wash your hands.
Thank you.
another Valkyrie.
Here in Niflheim? Of all the places.
Oh, yes, we're
freedom.
Yes. You are free now.
My sisters, have they suffered the same fate?
Yes. But we'll save them.
You are both very brave. I wish you luck. Valhalla awaits.
Both? She didn't even notice me.
They want to be saved. How do they put up such a fight?
They are fierce opponents. It is good for you.
You know, most parents just want their children to get a full night's sleep.
The spinning blades were Evaldi's favorite. I always thought them a bit garish. Let the Draugr get you. Ready and ready. Well, scrounge around a bit more and we'll build something then.
Scare up that alchemist, what needed finding? Check back soon.
Time has passed than you likely realize. The snowfall that began when you slew Baldur becomes immense. The stuff of omens.
Omens for the coming of winter.
Not just any winter, but a great winter to span three summers. And when it's done, Ragnarok begins.
Ragnarok from snow.
Aye, snow. Lots more snow. And then the end of the bloody world. In that approximate order.
Another prophecy.
No, brother. Prophecy doesn't expect this for 100 more winters at least. You've changed something. Prophecy didn't count on you.
I'm telling you, it's Fimbulwinter. I can feel it in my throat. This is the big one.
Stop saying that. Oh, you're making me very nervous. It was bound to snow sooner or later.
That ain't just snow, and you know it. It's the end time.
How dare you make me?
Guys,
discussing the weather. Bit of a cold snap lately.
What he means is the winter's upon us, boys. The winner to end all winners. I can feel it in my throat.
Yeah, we heard.
So if you're heading home, try to keep moving, and also to not die.
Or if you're not heading home, same advice.
I can't believe you ate it. Okay. Obviously the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up the hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved.
and stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear.
But her magic was so much stronger than his.
After so much time together, he knew her vulnerabilities and exploited them to craft curses she could never break.
Oh, like not being able to leave Midgard.
Worse still, he robbed her of her warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell.
You know what?
I'll tell this one later.
One more for the collection. Another name. Air!
Another Valkyrie. That's no coincidence. But who'd have etched them on Tyr's braziers?
Found anything good in Fafnir's storeroom? Like, maybe a whetstone?
Gulvi's bones pulse with magic.
It must be Gulvi. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of them.
The spirit lies to the brain.
How do you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
No,
very little.
We go die!
Light him on your side.
I always wonder what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon.